We are grateful to the Lord who has given us another day, a new beginning, and He is giving us new life. He is giving us new opportunities for each day. So we are grateful to the Lord who has given us this day. We are also grateful to the Lord that people are being born, however much many are dying, but then there are those who are being born. So we celebrate with those who are celebrating their birthdays today. We congratulate them and then pray for them that they may enjoy the goodness of this world. Na longo na matovu anet, na mlindwa Scovia, Mweluka Arthur, Miss Mubangi Zibabi, and Mr. Chinji Ivan. May you enjoy your day and a happy birthday to you. As we are born in this world, we all find challenges, burdens, difficulties, and hardships in this life. So from the readings we've had today, I call upon all of us to reflect on the theme, Let the Lord Handle Your Burdens. Leko mukama akwate kuchikoli gocho. Let the Lord handle your burdens. The gospel we've had today, it has encouraging words from the Lord. He has told us, come to me, all who are, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. My yoke is easy and my burden is light. These are encouraging words from the Lord, which He is giving us today. We are enjoying this life, but then the burdens are in this life. Sometimes the Lord has given us burdens, and He has allowed us to go through lives of hardship, which are so difficult for us, all too heavy for us to bear. Like being laid off from your job, not having what to eat at home, having illnesses of all kinds, especially like nowadays COVID-19, letting the married persons mess up their families, letting the people of bad heart to be with you and to be your friends, letting terrible and unbearable leaders be in authority in your country and in your areas or communities, letting the spouses hurt others, letting the physical, mental, and spiritual burdens happen in our lives. When all this happens, then we question God, why is this all happening in our lives? But you can think that nobody is caring about you, because when we look around, everyone is enjoying their lives as if nothing wrong is going on. No one, many times, is caring about us. We tend to think that everyone has to care for us. We may be mistaken if we think that the people shall care for us. We start asking the Lord, because we have failed to understand, what wrong did I do to you, dear God? Why is it that I'm suffering this much? What did I do that I'm supposed to suffer like this? We fail to understand that God is with us in all situations. We are suffering because God is trying us, but He is teaching us something. When Moses was called by the Lord, from the reading we've had today, Moses was led by the Lord, and he was told to go and liberate the people of the Lord. The Lord whom we serve, the Lord who created us, the Lord who is keeping us safe, He is a liberating God. He is ready to liberate us from all our burdens. We need to know something, dear brothers and sisters, that the troubles, the trials, a part of every human being who is born and who is in this world. So we cannot do away with them. But then what do we have to do? We need to know the power of the Lord. We need to put our trust in the Lord. We only need to cast our burdens to him so that he may lead us. Moses cast the burden to the Lord because he had feared to go and face the king. He cast the burden to the Lord and the Lord helped him. He was able to lead the children of the Lord from exile. Saint Bonaventure, whose feast day is today, he also put his trust in the Lord. It wasn't so easy for him to become a successful and great person, but he cast his burden to the Lord and he gave him the wisdom which he used to help this world sail and go through the many challenges which are theological or philosophical. We need also to cast our burdens to the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, the troubles and trials, the difficulties are going to come on in our ways, but Jesus teaches us what we need to do. Number one, we need to know and we need to go to the right people. If we are to be free, we need to go to the right people. Secondly, we need to go to the right places. And then thirdly, we need to take the burdens to the right persons. Some of us, we take our burdens to wrong places. We take our burdens to wrong people. We take our burdens to unresponsible persons. The only place where we have to take our burdens is the church, is that place where the Lord is. The person to whom we need to take our burdens is the Lord, the creator of us all, who will free us from all these burdens. May we let go of the people who are not helping us, the places which are not right. We may take our burdens to the shrines. We may take our burdens to the people who will give us wrong counsel and guidance, which will lead us into trouble. But the Lord will never lead you into trouble. He'll just only get you out of your trouble. May we always be courageous to go to that Lord. He is always ready to take our burdens. It's only we who need to go to him and tell him our burdens. Let us go to that Lord who is telling us that, let me be your umbrella and I cover you. Let me be your driver. Let me be your light. He will really take our burdens from us. We may be having those heavy burdens, but the Lord is taking them to be so light. When we take the burden of the Lord or the yoke of the Lord, we shall be enjoying his mercy, his graces, and he will see us through all what we are, what is challenging us. We don't need to worry. We don't need to curse the Lord. We don't need to fight. We just only need to go to the Lord and put him in the play so that he may give us what we need. Let us always pray until something happens in our lives. Let us place our burdens in to the Lord. He will liberate us from these burdens. Tutwale bikoligo bya feri omukama atuyambe bwe tunabitwala yo tagenda kulemererwa kubitujjako. Embeera ne bwebeera efaanana etya tesobola mulemerera, nga bwe yayamba Abayisirayiri bwatyo naffe bwajjo tuyamba. Musa yali atidde naye bwe yabikwasa omukama yamuyamba byonna n'abisobola. Naffe tubikwasa omukama nga tubimutwalira mu kifo ekituufu, nga tubimutwalira kubanga ye yasinga, tuleme kubitwalira abantu bakyamu abajja okutubuzaabuza. Omukama ffenna atuyambe, nga tuyita mu Bonaventure omutuukirivu, tusobole okubanga naffe tukozesa amagezi n'obuvumu okuyita mu bigezo by'ensi eno.